Hello. I'll try to make this brief. It's got to be around 2 in the morning on an early Wednesday morning, and I had dozed off a little bit, and then I couldn't sleep. So I made myself a little snack, and I find that if I eat a little something, I can sleep, and then try to sleep right afterwards. I will sleep for maybe 3 hours in a row, which is a lot for me now, since my husband here, John, died. In my arms, right here beside me. Anyhow, sorry, I said I would be brief. I woke to the sound of an email coming in, as well as you might hear German language being spoken in the background. I woke to, because the house is lonely, I've taken to streaming something constantly on the monitor. We don't have a television, but I'll stream something simple like YouTube. And I guess YouTube learns a little something about who you are. And I woke to the sound of email and the sound of someone speaking German. And I thought, and I could understand, I can't speak much, but I can understand a little. And so much of it I think I understand out of context. And so it's a man who's talking about the latest Audi estate wagon SUV. That's the SQ7 wagon. Anyhow, it makes me laugh because I know that it wasn't so many years ago. Audis, like when we met, Audis in Germany were like the cars, they were not cool. They were the cars that old people bought. Maybe like a Buick or a Cadillac here was in the 80s or 90s, you know, or late 80s. It was uncool. But now, you know, an Audi is considered quite cool. And even a wagon. Anyhow, so John and I, we laughed about that. The two things. So the email was my pen pal in New Zealand. She let me know she is traveling very soon to meet up with her daughter who's arrived in San Francisco from Hong Kong. For triple negative breast cancer treatment. Oh, it's raining. We had like one clap of thunder. That's a thunderstorm for this part of the country. One. So I let my pen pal know. It's awful. But it's going to be okay, and to be forward-looking. My John had a cancer. It wasn't so much the cancer that shortened his life. It was a couple of pretty horrible mistakes that happened during his treatment that limited his options of treatment. But I can't change that. My point, sorry. I woke here in German in the email, and I wrote my pen pal and sent, and I'm New Zealand, to safe journey, and it will be okay. And then I thought about, oh, it's appropriate I'm hearing German, because in a few days, our German friends, when we met in the summer, and by winter, the company I worked for went bankrupt and left me a little severance check, and I had brought it home to John, and I asked him what we should do with it, and he said immediately, let's go buy a second-hand older Volkswagen camper, a German camper, and go to Baja, Mexico for the winter. Well, we met the couple from Frankfurt, who are coming in a few days to help me with a project, some projects around here that I need to do, and I have mixed emotions about that. I'm embarrassed to need help, and I'm embarrassed to ask them to help me while they're on their precious few holidays. But I'm grateful. My people in New Zealand told me to look up the word grace, and I'm trying. It's just, I'm gracious personally, it's just inside, it makes me sad that I don't want them to worry about me. So, this is just a couple of seasons ago, and that's my John, and that's me, and we're pretending like it's really, really windy, and it's not windy at all. And right over from the edge is our German friends, and they've got their car, and they're getting ready to go. And I'm thinking, I don't even have a kite big enough, so I'm thinking I'm not going to go. You know, there's all this windsurfing and kite surfing equipment inside there. Anyhow, they were getting ready to go. And we were making fun of the fact that there was hardly any wind. And that's my Johnny holding me, you know, so I don't blow away. And he's wearing his knit cap he got during his transplant. But somehow it's fitting that I'm woke to hearing German language, and he's talking about cars, and this friend, this couple, I had seen them the year before in Mexico when I was working there, and I was friends with some Bavarian Germans who are traveling, and I said, oh, there's some other Germans up the beach. And the woman listened, and she said, no, they're East Germans. And I didn't realize there was so much bias between different parts of Germany. Reunification wasn't that old back then. So she didn't want to meet them. She thought they were East German, but they were from Frankfurt, which does have a bit of a different accent than people living in the South or, you know, Bavaria. But anyhow, the next year we went, we had only been together for a few months, and I went up to them and I told them that story and they laughed and laughed. Oh no, we're not East German. And so what? that's what we thought too. Anyhow, but I'm really lonely. I miss him so very much. I miss my husband. I held him. He died right here beside me in our bed, and I held him. And I'm worried. I'm panicking more. And I'm panicked now about having someone help me. And I'm worried about my pen pal traveling to help her daughter who's facing a very serious, but it's a beatable cancer, and we need to keep believing it's beatable. Triple negative breast cancer. All cancers are horrible. Well, almost. I mean, somebody who complains about a little, you know, basal cell carcinoma or squamish cell carcinoma, you know, the little skin things you get from a life in the sun. No, that's not cancer. So I don't want to hear you talk or whine about it. It can, if you don't take care of it, it can get bad, but you can take care of it. But, anyhow, I better finish. This is my very cute husband, and he's, we're trying to make each other laugh by pretending it's windy. I miss him so much.